is gonna take it out on your kids.
Wasting time watching the world pass us by.
Hey, hey, it's Jay Gray. Welcome back to We and Wednesday. This week we're talking about religion. Yeah. Specifically, we're comparing the rules of a couple of religions. We're going to be talking about Christianity and Satanism today. I may in the future do a video where I talk about some other religions, like Buddhism and Islam specifically. But today we're just talking about Christianity and Satanism. And I'm going to be reading through the rules and basically giving an opinion on it. And then maybe at the end comparing some of them. Talking about some of the big differences and maybe some of the smaller ones. So first of all, I'm going to talk about Christianity. Yeah, we know how this is going to go. So, Christianity. First of all, something very interesting about the Christianity rules. When you compare them to all of the others, and I'm just talking about Satanism, right? Like, just this is the one bit where I'm going to bring in everything else. So, most of them, they've just got, like, rules or suggestions or things where they're like, hey, I mean, it'd be great if you could do this, but, like, not totally necessary, and, you know. And then there are a couple where it's like, hey, you know, these are, like, standard things for us. But they're all called something like rules or precepts or another word that basically means, like, suggestions or, like, rituals or something like that. And then Christianity, you've got commandments. So, I mean, commandments, I don't know. I mean, it's just one of those things that sound like, you better do this or else kind of thing, you know? I don't know. I mean, that's how it comes across to me. Anyway, so I guess we'd better get into this. So the first Christian rule, the first of the Ten Commandments, is, I am the Lord thy God, thou shalt not have any gods before me. Or as it was written in the Bible, and God said all these words, I am the Lord, took you out of the land Egypt, out of the prison house, you are to have no other gods but me. So basically, I mean, that sort of comes across as like, yep, I am the most important thing in the world. And you better acknowledge it. Okay. Alright. Number two. You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything. Or as the Bible puts it, you are not to make an image of anything in heaven or on the earth, or in the waters under the earth. You may not go down on your faces before them or give them worship. For I, the Lord your God, am a God who will not give his honor to another. And I will send punishment on the children for the wrongdoing of their fathers to the third and fourth generation of my haters. And I will have mercy through 1,000 generations on those who have love for me and keep my laws. So if you don't like me and appreciate me and just listen and respect everything I do, I will take it out on your kids and your kids' kids. What? What are you? Are you God or are you Hitler? What the hell, man? What the hell? Three. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God. As the Bible puts it, you are not to make use of the name of the Lord your God for an evil purpose. Whoever takes the Lord's name on his lips for an evil purpose will be judged a sinner by the Lord. Alright, so that's like, don't say things like, oh my God, or Jesus Christ, you know, in exclamation, like those kind of things. Alright, okay, I mean, I guess for a God, I mean, that's fair enough. Christians do it anyway, let's just throw that out there, they do it anyway! Four, remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. Or as this puts it, keep in memory the Sabbath and let it be a holy day. On 6 days do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On that day you are to do no work, you or your son or your daughter, your manservant or your womanservant, your cattle or the man from a strange country who is living among you. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth and the sea and everything in them, and took his rest on the seventh day. For this reason, the Lord has given his blessing to the seventh day and made it holy. Hey, how many Christians do you know that work on a Sunday? Just out of curiosity. 5. Honor your father and your mother. Let's pause it. Give honor to your father and to your mother, so that our life may be long in the land which the Lord your God is giving you. Okay. Alright, I'm not going to comment on that one. 6. You shall not murder. Do not murder. 7. You shall not commit adultery. Do not be false to the married relation. 8. You shall not steal. Do not take the property of another. 9. You shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. Do not give false witness against your neighbor. 10. You shall not covet your neighbor's house, wife, or property. Let not your desire be turned to your neighbor's house, or his wife, or his manservant, or his womanservant, or his ox, or his ass, or anything which is his. Alright, so don't kill anyone, don't cheat, don't steal anything, don't lie about your neighbors, and don't want anything that belongs to someone else. Alright, that's cool. So the second half of those, I mean, I can kind of agree with, yeah, like that makes sense. But the first half is like, what? I mean, it's all about God and how if you don't follow him and put him above everything else in your life, he's gonna take it out on your kids. Satanism. The 11 satanic rules of the earth. So first of all, I actually want to go over a couple of definitions with you. So the first one is satanic, caused by or influenced by Satan. So the definition of Satan is Satan is the devil, from Hebrew Satan, meaning to plot against. First thing I want to point out there. So that basically means that the 11 satanic rules of the earth are plotting against the earth. I don't know, that's how it sort of comes across. And the last one we want to look at is the definition for devil. The definition for devil, which is in Christianity and Judaism, the devil is the spirit of evil and enemy of God. Or 2, an evil spirit. From Greek, diabolos, don't ask me to pronounce things, meaning slanderer, enemy, or devil. Okay. We're just going to keep that in mind, alright? We're just going to keep that in mind, yeah, okay. The enemy of God and an evil spirit. And we might talk about this again at the end. So the first of the 11 satanic rules of the earth is do not give opinions or advice unless you are asked. And I think that's pretty fair. And I agree with that about 90% of the time. 90-something percent of the time, maybe. I'm not sure exactly. I do think that most of the time, you know, if you just have an opinion out of nowhere, you should sort of keep it to yourself, unless it's super important and, like, life-changing and it's gonna do, like, good stuff. If you have an opinion and it's just gonna be negative and nasty, I think you should just shut up and just leave it alone. I do also think that if someone else is out there publicly expressing their opinion, that you should have every right to go and express yours right back at them. Go and get in a debate with them, I don't care. If someone else is expressing their opinion, I think that you have your right to express yours right back at them. But for the most part, just shut up. 2. Do not tell your troubles to others unless you are sure they want to hear them. This is a good one. Sometimes you shouldn't just, like, go out and just blurt out everything that's troubling you to, like, everyone that's around to listen. Some people don't want to hear it. Some people, it can be damaging for them to hear it. I mean, like, you don't really think about these consequences and the repercussions and the ramifications of the things that you say a lot of the time. But I mean, like, really think about it. Like, just really, really think about it. And if it's something that's actually really, you know, it's necessary to say, or there's a reason for it, then say it. Or if you're not sure if you should say it, ask if it's all right to disclose some information or, you know, let something out. Don't just go and message some random person and start blurting out random stuff that has nothing to do with them, because, like, they don't need to deal with it, those troubles. And I'm not saying that you should keep everything to yourself, but I mean, find the right people to talk to about it. Okay? Just... 3. When in another's lair, show him respect or else do not go there. I think that is a damn good one. If you're gonna be in my room, you're either gonna respect me or get the fuck out. And I mean, really, just get out. Don't come into my house and start being, like, hateful. Don't come into my house and start being transphobic. Like, what the hell were you thinking? Don't come into my house and start complaining about cats. Like, oh my gosh, just... no. Alright, if you're in someone else's house, respect them or GTFO. It's pretty simple. Alright, it's pretty simple. If you want to disrespect people, go and do it in your own house. Okay? Cool. Glad we got that sorted. 5. Do not make sexual advances unless you are given the mating signal. So, don't touch anyone sexually or touch anyone in general or advance on anyone or harass someone or assault someone or do anything sexual with anyone unless you have their permission and they have said it's okay. If you don't get a response, that's not an okay to do it. If you get a no, that is not an okay to do it. If you get a yes, clear, definitive yes, a clear, definitive, sober yes, then sure, go for it. Alright. 6. Do not take that which does not belong to you unless it is a burden to the other person and he cries out to be relieved. I do like this one too. It's basically saying don't steal shit and don't, like, take something off someone unless, like, you know, I don't know, I kind of picture, like, you know, someone's walking around and they're carrying, like, this big weighty box and they're struggling with it. Like, if, yeah, you can go and help them with that box, like, go and pick it up and carry it for them. I don't mean, like, steal it and run away with it and just take their shit. But, you know, I mean, that's kind of how I picture it. It might not be exactly what it's supposed to mean, but, like, don't steal shit. Don't steal shit. 7. Acknowledge the power of magic if you have employed it successfully to obtain your desires. If you deny the power of magic after having called upon it with success, you will lose all that you have obtained. Cool. So in other words, if Hagrid bursts into your room one night and says, "You're a wizard, Harry," or whatever your name is, and you start doing magic and all that, I mean, you don't, like, you know, turn around and be like, "Magic's not real." Acknowledge the power of magic. 8. Do not complain about anything to which you need not subject yourself. So if something has nothing to do with you, don't complain about it. A good example of this is cis people complaining about trans people having rights. 10. Do not kill non-human animals unless you are attacked or for your food. Do you guys hear that? All you people out there supporting animal racing, like greyhound racing, horse racing. All you people out there supporting animal fighting. All that kind of rubbish. Do not kill non-human animals unless you are attacked or for your food. And I feel like that sort of goes into don't, like, indirectly contribute to the killing of those animals as well. Indirectly or directly, because, you know, supporting those events, you could be doing either one depending on how much you're supporting them. 11. When walking in open territory, bother no one. If someone bothers you, ask him to stop. If he does not stop, destroy him. I like this one. I really like this one. So, if you're out, mind your own business. Don't bother people for no reason. Don't do it. If someone bothers you, ask them to stop. I'm not quite sure about the destroying them part. I feel like, you know, if we're talking about morals and, like, you know, what's good and what's probably a little bit less good, probably shouldn't destroy people. I mean, let's be real here. So where were we with that definition? The devil is the spirit of evil. Remember, Satan is the devil. The spirit of evil, or an evil spirit, an enemy. If you ask me, most of this doesn't sound really evil at all. Most of this seems like it should just be common sense. Respect people. Don't hurt people. Don't steal shit. Don't kill people for no reason, and don't bother people. That doesn't sound evil at all. I feel like some of y'all are full of shit. Hey, so thanks for watching this. Feel free to let me know what you think. If you have any other opinions you want to add, I'd love to hear them. I really would. Like, honestly. No, seriously, I'd love to hear them. I'm also thinking of doing another video kind of like this in the future, but instead of comparing the rules, comparing the sins. So that'll be going into the Wing It Wednesday vote list at some point. It's going to be going into the mix, and it'll be up at some point in the vote. So when it comes up, if you want to see that, go and vote for it. Speaking of which, go and vote for next week's video. I know you guys want to see something, but I don't know what you want to see, so let's go and find out, shall we? Again, thank you for watching this video. Feel free to let me know what you think, and if there's anything you want to see in the future, like any kind of video topics that you guys want to see, let me know. If there's anything you want me to talk about, or do, or whatever, let me know. I'll look into it. Thanks for watching this. I'll see you guys next time. Don't forget to go and vote for next week. Stay awesome. Honestly, it's things like this that makes me think that most of the world's population is full of shit.